Yorkshire.
Kevin Cox.
I'm just glad my surname ain't King.
What about Rhino Room?
No, I've had Wayne Reed's a book, I've had all of that. See, I know what my first name is in what Greek mythology is. Supposedly
what's
means wagon builder, which is quite ironic because I pretty much aced woodwork at school, so I suppose it kind of means something.
Well, hey!
I actually hate it. See, my name come up, my mum decided she didn't want to name me something that people could short. But she gave me Wayne.
Why?
To Wayne Nidge. And then took the Wayne away, and now she just calls me Nidgey, so she defeated her.
Nidgey.
So, I hate it.
See, my mum was called Lynn, so that people could. Because she wanted to be called Linda, and then everyone called her Lynn. So then everyone actually goes, I'm Linda! And she's like, my name's Lynn. Just to avoid having it shortened down. My name means in Greek. Let's see.
.com?
Meanings of names. Meaningsofnames.com. Here we go, right. Search first name, Simon. Let's have a look.
This is going to be great.
Okay.
Start something here.
I'll tell you what, if we're going to make fun of someone's names, then we should start with our own, yeah.
Simon means little hyena. Oh, excellent!
That's so true.
Obedient, listening, little hyena. Excellent. Right. Roy.
Ooh, this ought to be good.
Oh! Which one do you want to go for?
Correct.
Because if you were Roy in Ireland, it would mean you were king.
There you go.
France. However, if you're just Gaelic or Celtic or Scottish, then it just means you're ginger.
Well, then king is the correct
one. You could be a ginger king.
Ginger bread king.
Oh, that could mean you've made iron brew.
Oh. They say there's only two people know the recipe for that. He must be one of them.
Yoakim.
That explains the bad taste of his food.
Yoakim, I don't think he'll be pleased with yours.
I don't think my name is outside of
Norway. It says the Hebrew version, which origins from Israel, means may Jehovah exalt, or may God prepare for something.
Yeah.
So you're basically a plan, or you could just be the apocalypse. I'm not quite sure.
That's true.
It's all gone horribly wrong.
Yeah.
Oh dear, Jarno Hojvic back in the Rare Endurance team in 12th position. Welcome back to the track for him, and welcome back in 3rd place, Jan Larsen. That's probably why he called everyone back in. So, Nanny is out on track for 05 Motorsports in 3rd. Who else is in the house? Esben, let's see if we've got anywhere else.
Remember that you can spell Esben two ways.
Esben does mean God.
Damn.
No. Esben rules the world!
Type in semen and see if it says the second coming.
I think my name means bear or something. But anyway, I am gonna go back to my team channel, and since I'm contractually obligated to say this, representing the R4R Massive.
Well, thank you very much for joining us. Take care. And good luck with the rest as well.
And we have lost Yuri Geisen, Eason out on the track.
Somewhere in the tunnel.
Yeah, Yuri, that must have been a driver change because he wasn't there a second ago. So Yuri, he's not had much luck lately, has he? Mr. Chisholm, which admittedly is another name that sounds suspiciously like it should be Seaman as well. And it's 21st position for SRV and GT2. Not good. Out of the race. That brings us down to just 24 teams left now.
At least you can pronounce his name.
We do have enough
for a year and a half thinking it was
Jinjsen? I'm not sure. Well, we've got. Oh, I was going to say that wrong as well. Jeff Fika is in the house. Welcome, Jeff.
Hello.
How you doing? Mute. Yeah, mute the podcast, or mute other people's, or something. How you doing?
I just thought I'd stop down here, and because I see a lot of familiar names.
But you're not familiar to me, unless it's that one time at band camp.
I don't recall.
He was the one with the trumpet up his doobie what's it?
And Stephen Fry.
I tell you what.
That was a dream. Oh, sorry.
QI wasn't the letters I was thinking. Oh, SRVN. Say runtime error. So, runtime error for Yuri Jizin, another one. So, obviously, lots of R-Factor dramas today for people, so that's why they're out. So, how are you affiliated to this all then, Jeff?
Well, I race with Roy in RBR, Richard Burns.
Now he knows who you are.
No, I remember. Joachim, remember. I saw it earlier, too.
So, more or less, I kind of wanted to come down here and say hi to Roy, because, you know, after all the times that we've spent online without chatting, I finally get a chance to chat.
Oh. So, does that mean that actually Roy has blocked you on MSN?
I have no idea.
Maybe should we all hush for a second and let them have their first initial vocal contact with each other?
Yeah, then you have to wait for a couple of minutes.
Okay. Before we do that, though, Jeff in German means that you are divinely peaceful.
Sweet, and that's exactly how I am.
You just sound stoned, really. But yeah.
Really?
No, you just sound chilled out, mate. Anyway. Welcome to Roy. This isn't going very well, guys. Need to talk. Who brought the roses?
Roy just came back with a dinner plate.
I have to say, you do have a very good commentating voice. I've watched a lot of the live feeds and stuff. You do good work.
Oh, thank you very much. Very kind of you to say so.
It'll be blushing now, see?
Oh, shocks. No, it's always my pleasure to take part and help everything out. So, as long as people are happy to sit here and listen to my trash, it's all good. So, thank you.
It's not any worse than Jeremy Kyle.
Boo. But we don't have food fights on here, we have pixel fights.
There was digital squirrels.
Squirrel! As Ricardo, as Viedo on your screen, you're not missing any particular battles out on track. Closest ones that we have got at the moment are possibly 6th and 7th for on the same lap, Enos Doughty and Attila Kiss for 6th and 7th leading the P2 class. And aside from that, excuse me, we've still got the Schroten brothers, HG Hansen for RMI Motorsport, and Remco De Wilde recovering for SRH Zeno. We're all on the same lap further back, but apart from that, everyone else is spread out now that Richard Roberts has pulled away a little bit from Richard Blocker for World Connect and Rare Insurance.
Back to the TSR front.
Excuse me. Oh well, Jeff, so do you race in, or are you racing here today, or...?
No, I actually just,
That was some strange background noise.
That was like me in serious replay delay, that was. It's always off-putting. I remember when I'd done a broadcast once where I couldn't work out what I was doing. And what I had was I had my broadcast running in the background, but I couldn't work out where it was. And all I kept doing was having to purposely block myself out, and it didn't happen.
Oh, that was a lag.
So, is the race...
It was not a lag. Roberts. Position
20.
Stop replay.
The live time. If you go into the... Go into R-Factor, in the forums, the R-Factor leagues, or the LMS. I think it's in... There's an info thread, and the live time is in there.
mirror the standings on your screen.
No, I can't. Hang on. It wasn't letting me do a replay back.
In the end of the Mulsanne Strait, you just went through the corner and straight ahead.
Oh. Somehow, he's still going, though.
Yeah.
And that car has had its fair share of dramas today, a little bit. Somehow, it's still going third in class. But it has...
Beatles are cars.
They are indeed. Wasn't Herbie a Beatle?
Yeah.
I remember... I went to Disneyland Paris last year. It's the first time I've ever been like abroad to just do something like a little show, and we went and saw the little motor car thing, and they had little Herbie on it, and they come out and you get sawn in half, and then half the car kind of like waltzes away a little bit. It's everyone loved Herbie. I've not seen dodgy remake with that dirty little slut lady in it. What's her name?
Don't bother.
Is it that bad?
Yeah.
And you looked at it and you thought,
Miss Watson. Oh, I can't think of her name.
Logan. Lindsay
Lohan.
Lindsay Lohan, that's it.
Yeah. Leslie Lohan. Whatever her name is. I don't know if she's supposed to be. That's it. Thank you, Yuri. For Lindsay Lohan. But yeah, that... I don't know. No. But I remember watching the old Herbies. I'll tell you what film I've never seen, and I've got it on my wish list to get. The 1970s, was it Grand Prix film? With Steve McQueen, is it in?
Oh, I've seen it.
I've never seen it. Is it good?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You have to be interested to like it, but I don't know.
Sure, it was sure. Great.
And the 1969 or something, Gone in 60 Seconds, also a great video.
Oh, yeah, I've not seen that either.
Le Mans with Steve McQueen.
That must be the one I'm thinking of as well, because I've not seen any of...
Must have collection.
Okay. Have we all seen the Senna documentary?
Yep, got that.
That's a good film. That's good. I do recommend that, actually, because it sees him in different lights. Justin Lee's off the track in 14th position and buried quite deep into the barrier, that looked like. Let me just see if I can get a replay back of it. With a little loop. Or is it just going to magically appear? Yeah, no, it's just going to magically appear. That's annoying. But... he's got phantom headlights.
Yeah.
And he's off the track again for Justin Lee for Arthur R. Massive. Sorry, Esben, but I think your driving style has filtered through to Justin's
car. I'll tell you what, I think it's about time for me to go into my car again, so...
My car?
Yeah, into the my Porsche. I will leave you to it, and hopefully I won't see you again until another couple of hours.
Good luck!
Thank you.
Awesome.
It's so quite funny that I've ended up in here, because Nigel... he said at one stage, he said, we thought we was going to have to come and drag him out. he accused me of stealing the limelight from Ryan. It's disgraceful. I've told him now, that's it, I'm halving their pay packet for this race. It's just rudeness.
Pay packet? Who are you, FSR?
Yeah, I do, I pay them. I've been sending them cheques for years, but they proclaim they've never arrived. I don't know what's happened. I have this habit of keep filing all my bills in the bin, so I've got a problem and they just disappear.
Ah.
But no, very, very, very dedicated.
Oscar Hardwick in the chat room has just called the RMI team the really massive incident Porsche. Excellent.
Well, I'm so glad Roy's out of the stream.
It's pulling off. That was just, that's the orange one again, isn't it?
Carl Middleton's into the pits from 13th position. That makes a
Nigel.
They brothers?
Father and son.
Aww.
Nigel's Cole's dad.
Awesome, I saw it. Let's see.
Neil Tarsman racing. Father and Oswald.
I never knew. As well, B's in the pits there, Jürgen, from 5th position for Atlantic Team. 4 laps down on the leaders now. As Lee has made it back too for Arthur R. Massive, so just a few little bits going on. what's going on down the order. Richard Roberts, he must have had dramas because he lost 10 seconds in the last lap. He was 10 seconds slower than what he was before. He's got to watch out because Richard Flocker is actually closing him down at 2 seconds a lap. There's about a minute between them, so give that about half hour, 40 minutes, they'll be all over each other quite soon. Michel Vogels is back in the downforce racing car in 22nd position. So that's all good too.
Rams Hoyden.
Can't see anything else too exciting elsewhere at the moment. Let's find a car that we've not really looked at for a little while. Should we go... Moin. Anyone got any preferences? Moin.
Yeah,
9.
The Ferris wheel!
Oh! Yeah, Ferris wheel loving. We need to do that.
Lock the camera.
I can't work it. It's all too much, especially now that I've had alcohol.
What's it like?
Okay. What's your team, Wayne, again?
Total Sim Race.
GT2? No, it wasn't GT2, was it? It was GT2.
P2.
So I was getting confused. It's not hard.
P2.
Carl Middleton, 13th position. I don't think we have seen much of him, actually, to be fair. So let's give him a little bit of love in. Let's jump on board. Oh, come on. That's the button.
And then you press V.
V?
Yeah.
Oh. Loving that. Not the wrong car.
Still enough tipples.
13th position, Total Sim Racing.
I think you're in the 14th car.
Have a look.
Number 2.
Well, I pressed 14. There we go, that's 14 Lee. 13 Middleton. Ah, yeah, I don't know what was going on there. Fat fingers. Alright. Let's see through the driver's eyes. What's going on?
Look in the mirror.
Show. It's quite interesting to see actually just how the car will just suddenly appear, and there's really not a lot that you get warning for. It's Magnus Dahlgren and Andreas Loeffler actually coming round to lap Carl Middleton, so you don't get much of a warning.
But you can't hear me, the bees,
I don't think I'd be able to do endurance racing because it would be... I don't trust myself with everyone else's things at hand. I don't know. I have done endurance racing, but I've done it where it's been... I do the entire run, and it's been like such a shortened race, and it's like a 3 hour and plus 24 hours and stuff, so...
The thing is, everyone's got the same belief. I don't know, it's like a lot of instinct learning curve, you just get out of the way.
Okay.
We'll have to train you.
Okay. Metacritic. Right. Metacritic. Let's see. The lowest scoring game of all time ever is. Yeah, I want to see what's considered the worst game ever. I thought we were supposed to set down with that. Metacritic's 10 best and worst games. That's of 2008. Scrogs Racing. Apparently, for the Wii. followed by, oh dear, Homey Rollers for the DS. How can you call a game that?
Got a big Jumper, Nintendo shop itself, for that one. We meant we are going to just take it, you know what.
Racing Team Manager, 28 out of 100 for the PC. I think I may have bought that. Probably. Actually, I can agree. There is not enough good F1 manager, or like racing team management sims anymore. Because the only people that do it is by the company called Calypso, and my god, they are awful. Because it's done to the point where the game doesn't actually recognise some of the letters, and when you press Z, it pops up Y. It's that badly coded.
I think that new one's supposed to be quite good, isn't it? The one they do on R&D here. I think that's sort of the latest and best one there is, as far as I'm aware.
I used to do the web browsing one, F1 Time. I got quite high up in that.
That's the one there that also just said IGP.
Oh, is that what it's now called?
I think so. I think it's free to a degree, but if you want to add certain stuff, you've got to basically pay X amount.
Okay.
They've written it's a pretty good manager.
Cool. I'll have a little look at that, because I actually got up to Division 2 in the F1 Time stuff when I used to do it. So that was quite cool. That worst scoring. I want to know. It's like when you go on IMDb and they've got the worst films ever rated. What is the worst film anyone's ever seen?
Ariel's Wedding.
Really?
Yep. And there's another one, an old them Kerry films from Harry Ernie, so they're a bit poop. And
was that Sex and the City?
Oh, cool. They're cool films. They are. No, it's
what?
Brokeback Mountain, I think, if you're a bloke, it's probably one of the worst films ever conceived.
No. I haven't watched one.
As my now ex-wife tried to get me to sit down and watch it, and I think I watched the first 5 minutes.
Is that why she's an ex-wife now?
Well, no, but it didn't go down.
Nice.
I think it was, 5 minutes in and they started kissing, and I soon went upstairs.
Oh.
It's not my cup of tea, I think it's more, I think it literally is a chick flick.
Do you know what? As a man of a certain persuasion, I thought it was shat. So, I have sat and watched it, and I was bored to tears. But the problem was I know he's died, and I know everyone says that he's a great actor. But Heath Ledger mumbles his way through that entire film, and at the end of it, Jake Gyllenhaal dies. Sorry to ruin it if anyone really dared bother to watch it. He dies, and then Heath Ledger grabs his coat, and he's all like, he says something that's supposed to make everyone cry and go, oh, it's so thingy bob. But I remember going to see it, and I couldn't work out what he said, and I went, what did he say? Probably ruined it for loads of people. So sorry, world. But oh, it's a god awful film.
Yep. Plenty out there.
Oh yeah.
One Sylvester Stallone, that Copland.
Mark Urban's
That's
on
a bit of a disappointment as well.
Yeah, Mark Urban's facing the wrong way in 19th position for 25 Motorsport. That won't help him continue to be chased down by Richard Blocker. Brandon Warren's
flat tire, I think.
Yeah, he is all keeping going back to the pits. Richard Blocker's not far behind. So that could be a potential change of position. That's second overall in the GT2 category. So that's not going well. GT2s are getting bumped off quite quickly, aren't they? So they're not helping themselves. Brandon Warren's taken over the World Connect competition car.
Is that 05 Motorsport there in difficult?
Yeah, 25 Motorsports. Not looking good. Let's see if he can make it back to the pits. Just got this little chicane to go.
Ribbons are cool, film. They say it's...
What is?
Oscar saying it's a bad film.
Round she goes. That's how David Coulthard is that.
Yep.
Driven.
Sylvester Stallone, the car.
Yeah.
They always someone would do it in an F1 film.
Well, they was looking at doing an F1 film, wasn't they? Who was it that was going round?
No. Driven wasn't that the car?
Yeah.
There's that a bit of thinking it. The other one there, Chab Car, I think it was based on.
Yeah, because doesn't Shauna Lacey appear in it? Or am I thinking of Shake and Bake, whatever that one was. Talladega Nights.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Right, Talladega Nights was quite good.
Mark Urban has made it back to the pits, so that's helped out. Richard Blocker, they're still going around. Let's have a quick look at Brandon Warren, who's just joined the race in 21st position, as we had him helpfully pop in.
Oh, there we go. Apparently Oscar says that Driven was meant to one film.
Okay, Roy's back with us. You're not in the car.
Yeah, I love being in team manager and having drivers that say, well, you know, I can go another hour.
So Roy puts his feet up.
I don't think he wants to kill me. But the worst film ever, and I mean ever, it's Rider 2000.
What 2000?
Knight Rider 2000. You remember the series Knight Rider?
Yep.
Yeah.
The 1.5 hour movie version of it with a newer kit.
Oh no, you can't revamp kit.
Ugh, that's the worst 1.5 hour of my life.
You'll never get it back either.
No. I'm thinking of suing the company who made it.
Blair Witch Project, that was awful.
Oh, wasn't it just...
No wonder everyone was sick, it's because they can't hold a camera.
No, I know, I mean, if you wanted to watch an hour and a half of someone running around with a camera, you could just take a mirror and run around and look at yourself.
Then you could watch one of our more movies.
The cinema to watch it.
I'm not watching one of your home movies, Roy.
Well, you know, when we were... how long ago? Was it 10-15 years ago or something, we had a video camera and we had all these wacky ideas running
around.
When
the race started.
Yeah. Yeah, running around with a video camera in the summer vacation and... Well, we were highly creative back then.
It sounds so bad.
Joachim is almost ashamed to watch those old...
I still make movies, but it includes cars. Reckless driving.
Yeah. Well, we did all kinds of things, jumping through trees and crashing bicycles and everything.
Yeah. Sounds like the Norwegian version of Jackass or whatever it is.
Yes. Wow.
Yeah, good point.
Well, the movies itself weren't that long, but the blooper reel that was behind it. Oh.
Yeah. It was like 2 minutes of video and then 4 hours of bloopers.
Nick Rowland just popped. An F1 film that is coming out next year is called Rush, about the rivalry between Niki Lauda and James Hunt. Oliver Wilde is in it.
Heard of them.
I do like that very much. That's because Nick Rowland, if anything has boobies, you're in. So. Oh, cool. I've never even heard of that, so I shall keep that on my radar. Cheers, Nick. So. Rush is the name of that title. We'll keep an eye out for that. I've noticed, actually, because the Senna documentary has done so well, there was one that's come out about the TT person. I've forgotten who it was. I want to say Carl Fogarty, but it's not. About the TT Isle of Man stuff. And that's been in the charts for a little while. I don't know if anyone's watched that and seen if it's any good. That'd be a no. Hopefully someone in the chat room will let me. Maybe not. Possibly. I could just be making it up. Who knows anymore? It's close enough for third place in the P2 category. Magnus Dahlgren for ME Racing has just actually unlapped himself. Is that because Kaz is in the pits? I'm not sure. No. But Ricardo Azevedo for Thames International has got Andreas Loffler for the Black Rebels. None too far behind, so that's going quite nicely. Although Loffler's just done two slow laps, so that may take a little while to get there. I think the worst film I've ever seen in my life, and then felt so compelled to go and buy it, is called The Granny. Because what we used to do, me and my mates, when we discovered that we could rent out 18s at Blockbuster Video, even though we weren't. And I know, illegals. It's basically some kind of university film that's been done on like £10, and someone just puts on a rubber granny mask and then tries to kill people. But they do it really stupidly, like we've got like someone being strangled with a Tesco bag and someone gets their eye poked out with a biro because they don't have any other special effects. So that's not so grand there. I'm just going to stop the rundown through the order because Brandon Kaczmarek has been caught by Attila Kish. Arthur R versus Simcoe in the battle for the P2 lead as Hansen there's off the track in the background. So thank you to Ryan for spotting that. Mummy is good. And let's see how that gets on. There's a couple of drivers between them all, but let's see excuse me, how they get on. Petter Kaz is just lapping them all. And there's the stand-ins on your screen just for now. I think it's time for another beer. I'll be 2 seconds.
Another one already?
Don't judge me.
I passed 2 seconds a long time ago. Closing up on 10.
And Petter Kaczmarek goes into the pits.
Oh no! Is it going to be a driver's swap? Yes, it's fuel and...
I think it's just fuel and tires.
It's right. Been that so long.
I head back in to retake the jam now, because I think we'll be things abducted. Well, I should be back on after my next stint.
Okay, you're all.
Speak to you later.
Look at that! It was a driver swap. Say something and they do the complete opposite. Rickard Hell standing behind the wheel of the leading Torrent Motorsport P1 car.
Don't give me $1 million.
I'll tell you what, whenever George invites some new cars into the P1 category, they go straight to the top of the field.
Yeah, he really should stop doing that.
There you go, I shouldn't have started the season with a new car, I should be invited in.
Yeah.
Later on. Oh well, what can you do?
You need to pay your driver more, maybe a
little bit. There is this battle between. Well, where did he go? Where did he go? No. I had on my screen as well. Got Andreas Löffler in between Kaczmarek. Yes. It's not quite a fight, but it's not that far off either.
It's close.
Löffler, of course, is a couple laps down on these guys.
It's just 3 seconds between Kaczmarek and Kish.
I'm getting closer for each lap.
Yeah.
If I remember this now. Yeah.
Are Motorsport drove for the leaders?
Yeah, throw him on the sword.
We got quite a big gap now,
left
in the second place.
It was the last time I looked.
156 now.
156? Well, that's a...
Unless I was really wrong.
No, we can run it again.
The DNF list is quite big now.
Oh, look at those lines that were into the pits. Someone must have been running quite fast.
1-2 between Kasparek and Kishnel. Yeah, 156.
156 seconds between number 1 and number 2, that's quite a big margin.
Wider than my waistline.
Could you believe it?
Not really, no.
But your curse hasn't struck... Struck us this time, Simon.
Good stuff.
You were away and no one left.
That is grand.
Yeah, well, of course I didn't leave the car over to Richard and then we got Hillston, but...
Ah, Hillston's back.
Wayne Reed isn't in the... Tribus anymore. So someone left.
Yeah, okay.
Never mind. Well, he was a sport for coming in for quite a while anyway and chatting away to us. Always a pleasure to have drivers and people come along.
Promise to come back later.
Okay. We'll have to just decide in what type of takeaway I might do. So... Okay, Neil Tasker just saying, visit YouTube and search for Need for Speed Volante Cassiero to see how to turn your keyboard into a real feel steering wheel. So.
I don't know if the spell works.
Volente, V-O-L-E-N-T-E, and Cassiero is C-A-S-E-I-R-O. Swig a bit, come on. Ah, cheers everybody. Right. Let's get it going in the world. Right. Let's have it because what is the highest films on IMDb? I wonder. Do they have the highest and lowest on here?
Yeah, they have the
Oh yeah, top 250. See if I've actually watched any of them. Shawshank Redemption.
What happened with Cinemcheck?
Oh, have we lost someone?
Oh, look there.
Oh! Oh dearie me, and that's Justin Lee that's caught him. What happened there? Was that exiting? Is it entering the pits that's happened?
Missing the front of the car.
He's waiting for his
Yeah, I think so, because you can't get the car really repaired without the driver swap.
Well, Justin Lee, he's been in all kinds of dramas for our Massive since he took it over from the equally flamboyant Espen. I wanted to say S. Ransom.
That's a gaggle of cars running past on the track. No wonder it's so quiet out there, because everyone is racing on the same spot.
They're all together.
What on earth are they doing?
Kashmerick and Kish are still close. They've got Andreas Loeffler in between them, actually. So, that's going to be a good little battle.
Anders is quite big. It's a little over 10 minutes.
Yeah. So it's all going quite nicely. So as Kish continues to close down Kashmerick, I can just jump to that, because I'm not sure what Nemchek is doing, because he's still in the pits over a minute, getting damage repaired. I wonder if he will actually rejoin. But I'm going to, if it's alright for me to jump in, I'm just going to switch to... Here we are, there's Kish, and there you can see Kashmerick there being, well, getting Loeffler's trying to unlap himself there, Andreas, for the Black Rebels P2 car. I don't know how successful that will be. He's unlapped himself from Kish, But Kashmirik is going to have to let him go, but Kish is going to be right onto the back of him, so this could be a juicy battle that's coming up. Magnus Dahlgren is just ahead of them, about to be lapped by the people directly in front of him in the standings. So this is 6th, 7th, 8th and 10th all in the same screen.
Yep, and in the 12th position car of Hell Racing Team Hungary, now Sarusikis Peder has taken over the wheel, as expected.
Ah, okay, so that sorts out that in a way, but here comes Kish.
One second.
Who was it? Was in middle? That was it, George Talbot?
Excuse me. I couldn't quite see who it was, but... Yeah, it was George. Georgie Porge was in the middle there. So lots of clumps of drivers all stuck together, not helping each other along. And they've got Dahlgren now that they're coming up to. But Kish now has a clear track between himself and Brendan Kashmirik in the battle for the P2 lead. And it's suddenly all getting hot here on RGLNS. With 4.5 hours left to go. Yep, pat out that flame. I wanted to do a wheel on my way. In the jungle, the mighty jungle. Ooh,
and all this after just two beers.
I am a cheap night in. Endless entertainment. Anyway, so Kashmirik there still has Kish all over the back, and Kish is really closing him in quite quickly now that he's going to the slipstream margin. And he's flashing his lights there. I don't think he realises that actually Kashmirik is for position, not to be lapped. I'm sure he must know, but he was flashing his lights on the exit there. Dahlgren, in 8th position, is the next car behind Kish. So if they get to lap him, then he's lapped everyone up to himself. So he's done quite a good job to go past the fairest wheel of love. And,
David also has taken over the SRH Saddle Motorsport P2 car.
He's been in there like a horse draws. It's an English expression.
But we didn't hear it.
Okay, that's probably just as well. It's not late enough.
Okay.
And Kashmirik has got a couple of cars to try and get round now, because Ryan Walker's being lapped as he's rejoined for Total Sim Racing GT2. And Kashmirik versus Kish. Kish is trying to get round Dahlgren as well, and if he can succeed before the end of the straight, they've then got Richard Blocker to try and lap. Everyone's turned up all at once. He's straight into the slipstream. He's now got a clear run on Kashmirik for the first time so far this race. He pulls out side by side. He's got faster flake line street, and he's threw up into the lead of the P2 class. Can he hold it? Can Kashmirik? Is he going straight back inside for a dip in the slipstream in action? He is indeed. Going to try and take a breath and try and use the suction to slip up onto the back. Is he pulling out? They've got Richard Blocker to consider as they go over one of the many bumps on this circuit. And it's all going to end up. He is. And Blocker is going to block Kish from having a go back. And Kashmirik definitely takes over back, the lead of the R4R5 Motorsports on the P2 category. Kish straight into the slipstream, fancying another go back through again. Okay, how's he going to play this time?
Turn left and turn right.
Just a quick question, guys. How long is it since we last time around did the restart the broadcast?
We've got another 15 minutes. We've got another 15 minutes before we need to sort that one out.
We've done it 5 miles an hour.
And, and continuing with the driver swaps now, Reinz Janssen has taken over the Rare Endurance P1 car in 6th position in P1.
And Kish is ahead of
Oh yes, through he goes. Fantastic action from them. Dahlgren clinging on, although he is a lap behind. It's not a 6-7-8 pure scrap. But Kish is there. Kashmirik is fancying a nose, taking a little peekaboo action, but that's not a place to really overtake, so I don't think Kish would have been too worried. As the pair continue, hammer and tongs in the battle for P2, honours Atlantic Racing have got Stefan Persson 2 laps ahead, but he's in P1. So these two very much out on their own, battling for honours. Simcoe Hungarian versus R4R. And currently, Simcoe is winning.
Ooh!
Kashmir, it's not the ideal line into that corner, was it? But they've all made it back out the other side. Good going. Asviedo in 9th place there in the pits for Tams International. And that will mean Dahlgren has lapped everyone up to himself as well, because Asviedo then goes a lap behind Dahlgren. Blockers in 2 for, I think that would be Rare, wouldn't it? In 20th place. Over the hill they go.
Oh, and Simon. Meet Simon.
Oh, we've got a Simon in. We've got... Ah, Mr. Millerish is back in the cockpit. I'll get to you in a sec, mate. Because Brendan's fancying a nose back through again. Slipping straight into the clean air as best as he can. Excuse me. And he's going to take a second bite at it before he pulls out to have a go. And he's going to do the blocking back on Mr. Urban, who is going to basically force poor old Attila Kish. Once again, that's the second time that he's fallen for that error, and he's just been caught out with it, and Kashmirek will take sixth position if he can just hold on. Kish desperately trying to fight back through. Side by side, Kish has got a slightly better straight line speed. Yuri Jizing has just left the game.
Oh no,
he's already out. That was ages. Sorry, he just literally has clicked left the game, so he's sat there moosing it about for a bit. Here comes Kashmirek though, up into sixth position. Round the kink, and what can Kish do for a riposte, because it doesn't look like he's got anything left in him.
Allow me to fill you in with two more driver swaps. Kasper Mortensen has taken over the Thames International P2 car, 5th in P2 at the moment, and Robin Toll has taken over the Rare Endurance Team GT2 Porsche, 4th position in GT2.
Awesome, Asaurus, thank you very much, my eyes and ears. Kashmirek continues to hold on, and Kish is very much hounding him back. He'd done all the chasing, but has just not been able to have the driving nous to keep ahead of Brendan Kashmirek, who's using all the tricks in the book to make sure that Kish stays behind for Simcoe. This can't go on forever, although we do have 4.5 hours, so I wouldn't mind you keeping us entertained for a little bit. As Kashmirek continues to hold the position. How's your mate's stint then, Simon, while it keeps a bit quiet?
It was alright, a lot better than my first. Was doing some quick time on the
boat. You don't sound convinced.
Well, we're in a Spyker and it's just got no power, so you're sort of just racing yourself, because the Porsches and the Ferraris just, they just, well, I won't swear, but they just D you on the straight.
Oh, and Justin Lee has problems again.
Uh-oh, let's jump back to that. Where is he? Is he? He slipped down to 15th now because the Schroten pair have got through. So, but well, at least your stint is much, much better, and it bodes well. Are you getting back in the car again, or are you done for the day now?
I think Ryan's doing a double stint, and I'm getting back in and probably finishing.
Oh, okay, well, you've done well. Hopefully, yeah, you'll be able to get the car home.
Yeah, I think we're about safe, so it's not a bad accident. Our lack of power.
Lack of power, lack of testing. And lack of prior knowledge before you jumped in, so not
so
bad at all.
What's
the difference between the two as Justin Lee pops into the pits?
Well, the Ferrari's all about power and the Spyker's all about cornering speed, so you do have to get your lines totally different between each curve.
Okay, is Kish once again having a look at Kashmirek down at turn 2. Do you have any particular preference for how, for which car you would go for?
I'd prefer the Porsche 911 because I've always used it in the GT2 class, so it's a bit different coming to learn how to drive a Ferrari, then decide not to drive that, then change to the Spyker.
Oh, we'll call it multifaceted. It just means that you can be Awesomeosaurus at all different cars as it goes along. Wow. Well, it's good. Loeffler's in the pits from 10th position as once again Kish versus Kashmirek. Kish into the slipstream, not quite sealing the deal for Simcoe Hungarian team. Kashmirek is about to be robbed down the straight because of the slipstreaming fun that they have, but he'll just pop back in again and see if he can try and get back if he needs to. Ooh, Kish there just cutting back across almost a little bit too soon before they get to the kink. They've got traffic coming up ahead of Kevin Cox, who is in last position. I don't know if they're all going to arrive at the corner together again like what they did last time, but that is Kashmerik's best key. He's taken the inside line and got it. Kish has a slightly better exit, a bit slidey on the exit, but better nonetheless. He'll be back into the slipstream to have another go. Down at one of the many straights. Do you get bored on these straights, Si?
Yeah, I've actually got a magazine to read.
Excellent. Good stuff, good stuff.
I wouldn't recommend it though.
No.
Don't
do drugs.
How far ago was it that Gregory Grift took over the TBR car again?
Not
the developers, I think.
Yeah. So, not grand there. So, these two continue to battle for the P2 victory honours. GT2 still very much sorted out for 05 Motorsports. George Talbot currently leading that one. Rickard Helston still leads for Torrent Motorsports in the P1 class. There's the order on your screens there. Kish not quite so close this time to Kashmerik. Just looking at the lap times. Kashmerik's last ones, he'd done a 3:16 last time by. But before that, he'd done a couple of 18s, a 19 and 2:17s. Whereas Kish has done 4:17s and an 18, so they really are pretty much bang on the money for position wise as they pass Cerussi, Kiss Peter in the pits in 12th position for Hell Racing. And we must be right into the dead of night now.
Midnight marker.
Oh yeah, it must be like about 3-4 in the morning game time.
Yeah.
Light.
We've got the midnight blue going on.
Yeah, you can see it in the background.
So we're joined also alongside Simon Melhuish by Nick Rowland. Welcome, Nick.
A very good evening, mate. How are you doing on this very bitterly cold night?
Tell you, but seriously, in Harlow, -15. Really? Must it?
Well, according to Cameron, was that before it was -6 in Manchester.
Crikey.
You poor thing.
Oh, shush. We have a grain of snow and the country grinds to a halt. You have to have an apocalypse before anything happens to you guys. But we've still got snow outside my front door from when it snowed heavily last week. It's just it's not melted. And my heating bill has gone up. Loads. It's not good. But how was you doing before it all went horribly wrong, Nick? Because I don't even think you got out, did you?
I did the first thing for about an hour, and then I handed over to Matt. And then when he handed the car back to me, that's when we had the problem where it said I was in the car and I was able to rev it, but Matt was still in the car and driving it out, and then it just lagged both of us out and disconnected.
Ah.
Up to that point, it's going okay. I think we're fourth and fast at the time.
I suppose if you're going to retire, you might as well do it early, so then you've not put in so much of the effort.
There is that. It's a bit gutting, though, still. You're starting to get into the groove after about 3 hours, so which is a little bit disappointing.
Not to worry. But and that's, of course, brought the season to an end for yourselves, as once again, they're Kashmerik there, battling with Kish. Kish now through. Up into sixth position and leading, but Kashmerik certainly not done. Back for season four?
Going to do some more endurance racing throughout this year, even with the just trying to do more endurance and veer away from so much F1. It'd be nice to actually do something different for once. So yeah, I'll be doing season four, I suspect. Yeah.
There's only so much open wheel action you can take, I think, before it starts all becoming almost like the same type of thing. Agreed. But at least with endurance racing, you get the nice team ethos, so...
Well, that's the thing, it was actually interesting to get people who actually went to talk and share between teams as well, which is a rarity, it seems like, but it's the open paddock nature of endurance racing, I guess.
It is indeed, as we are on board with Brendan Kaczmarek, who is hunting down once again Attila Kish. They've got some more traffic coming up in the next couple of corners in the form of... Once it appears on my screen... Come on, come on. Oh, it's gone. Never mind. Yeah, anything else you'd like to add or chat about or send off us on a spiral tangent? Because we don't really need any more encouragement, but fire away.
Do you always win the spiral tangents? I think you've got that pretty much nailed, right? So I'll leave that to you. No, it's been a fun event to do. It's my first year of the year, obviously, just been doing all the F1 testing up until this point. But yeah, it's definitely a carry on. It's been good fun. I hope season 4 will be even better.
Super. You should come back for the 24-hour one next month.
I'm not here. I was going to do it. I'm actually in Barcelona though, so I can't. Unfortunately. Yeah, I'm
going
to... Yeah, I don't think... I'm going to leave that for the weekend, so yeah, I'm going to do that, unfortunately.
Awesome. Oh, enjoy that, mate. And I'm sure I shall catch up with you soon. And we shall see you out on track. In one form or another, I'm sure, because you're already out there bashing out that time, so...
Or bashing someone for some people.
Well, it's bashing one way or another.
Well,
I'm bashing a bishop. Here comes Kaczmarek. That was Piotr Dice in action. All of a sudden, just being sucked right up onto the back of Kish. Kaczmarek has gone for the inside line. He's going to be the one that breaks last. Can he hold it? He's gone in a bit deep, and that's Kish and Chiroux. Kish has gone round in seventh position, facing the wrong way. Come on! Change.
Ooh, one thing I want to point out when we're looking at this picture, look at the sky.
It's getting a smitty bit lighter.
Yeah. It's getting lighter for every minute.
Yeah.
And it looks absolutely beautiful.
Okay.
What is this?
Just trying to get a replay.
Oh, yeah.
Here we go. So, as they came flying down into the corners. Let's see what we can do. There we go. A little bit of slow-mo replay. There you can see. One car goes in.
Yeah.
I'm having a stroke. Brendan Kaczmarek going in far too deep. Attila Kish ended up kishing the curb on the left hand side, and round she goes.
Too much power in
this. So dodgy dealings there for Kish. He is back going again, as you can see on your screens, back in 7th position. That's kind of unfortunate. He brought that to a premature end, because that was a good old ding dong. But not to worry. That just means we can chat more of our guests!
Yeah! Woo! We should restart the stream any moment.
Oh yeah, should we do that? And then we'll be back for what is effectively the chat show version of Sim Racing. So, No.
Just roulette.
I've never
Russian
even...
Roulette.
Tell you what, that would probably be more...
Russian chat roulette.
Well, no, because if you go on Russian chat roulette, it's not that they're shooting at you, is it really? So, right, Attila Kish is in the pits. We're going to pit stop the same. We'll rejoin you shortly in the next minute or so here on simrace.tv for the next 2 hours of RD LMS here. Action. Oh, look at me, I hit the right button. Why is it not working?